श्री हरि गौर भक्त वृंदा जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्री हरि गौर भक्त वृंदा जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्री हरि गौर भक्त वृंदा हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधो जगतपति गोपेश गोपी कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कंचन गौरंगी राधे वृंदानेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्री बोलो श्री राधे गोलोकानंद भगवान की जय
जय
हरे कृष्णा
कृष्णा निशा कैसे हो?
अरे कृष्णा भी बड़ी
हरे कृष्णा तरुण
हरे कृष्णा गजेंद्र हरे कृष्णा एवरीवन
हरे कृष्णा
लगता है सब लॉन्ग वीकेंड पे पहले ही चले गए लगता है आज
समर है ना समर लॉन्ग वीकेंड जैसे चलता है
अभी थोड़ा और टाइम है बीच वगैरह पे जाने का
और क्या अपने दो हफ्ते का ब्रेक देके बिगाड़ दिया स्टूडेंट्स को
आई नो
आदत लग गई
कंटिन्यू रखना था वहां से लगता है
सही नहीं नहीं सबको ब्रेक चाहिए
समर एंड नाइस ठीक है शुरू करते हैं हमारा वी यस्टरडे हम लोग श्लोक 15th पे थे एंड दिस इज द कन्वर्सेशन बिटवीन मनु एंड लॉर्ड श्री ब्रह्मा राइट सो लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा के बॉडी से मनु का नाम है नाम याद है मनु का जो नाम है स्वयंभू थोड़ा कॉम्प्लेक्स है बट स्वयंभू एंड देन सतरूपा या सो दोनों ब्रह्मा जी के बॉडी से जेनरेट हुए और यूनिवर्स को एक्सपैंड करने की इच्छा जो थी ब्रह्मा जी को सो दैट्स व्हाट हैपेंस तो होने के बाद में फिर मनु बोल रहे हैं कि ओ मास्टर ऑफ डेमिगॉड्स राइट दैट्स व्हाट वी रीड यस्टरडे तो ब्रह्मा जी को एड्रेस कर रहे हैं प्लीज अटेम्प्ट टू लिफ्ट द अर्थ क्योंकि अर्थ इज मर्ज इन द ग्रेट वाटर या बिकॉज इट इज द ड्वेलिंग प्लेस फॉर ऑल द लिविंग एंटिटीज अगर लिविंग एंटिटीज को एक्सपैंड करना है तो अर्थ को पानी से बाहर निकालना पड़ेगा And it can be done by your endeavor and by the mercy of the Lord. So Manu बोल रहे हैं ब्रह्मा जी को कि आपके उससे and by the mercy of the Lord this can happen. Yeah. And that ocean we have seen that name of the ocean is Garbhodak ocean. Right. So we have Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. Right. Who is lying on the casual ocean. Right. और वहां से ही फिर ब्रह्मा जी पैदा होते हैं manifest होते हैं नाभि से जिस ओशियन पे विराजमान रहते हुए गर्भोदक ओशियन या विच फिल्स हाफ ऑफ द यूनिवर्स सो एनीवे सो मनु ये प्रार्थना कर रहे हैं ब्रह्मा जी से सो लेट्स रीड द नेक्स्ट श्लोक अनिल जी
जी हाँ मैत्रेय उवाच परमेष्ठी तुपां मध्ये तथा सन्नाम वेक्षगां कथमेनां समुन्नेश्य इति तद्यो धिया चिरम श्री मैत्रेय सेड दस सीइंग द अर्थ मर्ज इन द वाटर ब्रह्मा गेव हिज अटेंशन फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम टू हाउ इट कुड बी लिफ्टेड
हरे कृष्णा राइट सो लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा स्टार्टेड थिंकिंग हाउ कैन दिस be done yeah nisha
srujato me kshitir varbhi plavyamana rasam gata athatra kimanushte यमस्माभिः सर्गयोजिते यस्याहं हृदयादासं स इशो विदधातु मे। थोड़ा ऊपर जाएं।
Can you see?
Brahma thought, while I have been engaged in the process of creation, the earth has been indented by a deluge and has gone down into the depths of the ocean. What can we do who are engaged in this matter of creation? It is best to let the Almighty Lord direct us. Hare
Krishna. Right? So even Brahmaji is thinking, what should we do? And it's best that Almighty Lord direct us. It says here, Isho Vidhatu Me. Right? So that's what happens. Says the devotees of the Lord, who are all confidential servitors, are sometimes perplexed in the discharge of their respective duties. But they are never discouraged. So Lord Brahmaji had to create this world, right? Universe. Yeah. But they are never discouraged. They have full faith in the Lord, and He paves the way for the smooth progress of the devotee's duty. So anytime if we have issues in our duty, we pray to the Lord, like Lord Brahmaji himself prayed to the Lord, right? To get the earth out from the ocean. Tarun?
Iti abhi abhidyoyayato nasa vivarat sahasanaga varaha toko niragat Angusto Parimana Kaha. Oh, sinless Vidura, all of a sudden, while Brahma was engaged in thinking, a small form of a boar came out of his nostril. The measurement of the creature was not more than the upper portion of a thumb. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Right, so this chapter is about the Varaha avatar. Yeah, how the Varaha appeared. So when Lord Brahmaji is thinking how to get this earth out of the water, what happens all of a sudden is a small form of a boar came out of his nostril. Yeah? Says here, Nasa Vivarat Sanagha. What came out? Varahatoko. Yeah, like a small
boar.
Small form of a boar. Yeah? And that's the measurement was not more than the upper portion of a thumb is what happened. So Lord Vara. This is how he came out, right? And then see what happens next. Hare Krishna, Ravi.
Hare Krishna.
Krishna, Guri.
Tapasya bhi pasyata khasya khastha khene kila bharata gaja matra pravrathe tad buddhat mun mahata. O descendant of Bharata, while Brahma was observing him, let the boar become situated in the sky in a wonderful manifestation, as gigantic as great elephant. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Right. So he came out of the nostril, very small form, but as soon as he came out and as soon as Lord Brahma started observing him, what happened? He became situated in the sky. And gigantic like an elephant, right? Gajamatra pravardhade, pravrithe. Yeah, so he situated himself in the sky. Yeah, Anilji? Anilji?
Yeah. Marichi pramukhay, pramukhayar viprahe kumarayar manuna saha. रस्त्वा तस्सोकरम रूपम तर्कयामास चित्रधा struck with wonder at observing the wonderful boar-like form in the sky, Brahma with great brahmanas like Marichi as well as the Kumaras and Manu began to argue in various ways. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Right, so very interesting. So suddenly the boar came out. Small form, nice situated in the sky, like elephants. And so everyone, Lord Brahmaji, and you know, he had Marichi, if you remember Marichi Rishi, so out of now Rishi, Marichi is one of the Rishi, and I don't know if you remember, do you know which part of the body he, Marichi Muni, got manifested? Right? So Marichi Rishi man se peda hue, Brahma ji ke man se. जैसे देव ऋषि नारद मस्तिष्क से हुए, मरीचि ब्रह्मा जी के मन से हुए, जैसे वशिष्ठ मुनि श्वास से हुए, या एंड देन लाइक दैट दक्ष मुनि एंड एवरीवन एल्स भृगु ऋषि एंड केम आउट फ्रॉम डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी, मरीचि मुनि फ्रॉम मन से. सो देन लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा एंड मरीचि मुनि एंड एवरीवन सनत कुमार एंड मनु स्टार्टेड डिस्कसिंग लाइक व्हाट इज गोइंग ऑन. या
हिमेत सुकार व्याजम सत्वम दिव्यम वस्थितम अहो बताश्चर्यमिदम नासायामे विनि असृतम. इज दिस सम एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी एंटिटी कम इन द प्रिटेंस ऑफ अ बोर. इट इज वेरी वंडरफुल दैट ही हैज कम फ्रॉम माय नोज. हरे कृष्ण.
सो हु इज सेइंग दिस?
Brahmaji.
Yeah. So Brahmaji is saying, like, is this extraordinary entity? Yeah. He says, Satvam Divyam Divya Avastitam. Yeah. Extraordinary entity came in pretense, like Borka form leke. This extraordinary entity, you know, came out from my nose. So that's really wonderful. And then see the next shloka. Tarun.
दृष्टियो निग्यस्तो शिरो मात्रः कसंद गंधा शिला समः अपिस्वित भगवान एषा यज्ञो मे खेदयान मनः. ट्रांसलेशन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दिस बोर वाज सीन नो बिगर देन द टिप ऑफ अ थंब एंड विद इन अ मोमेंट इट वाज एज लार्ज एज अ स्टोन. माय माइंड पर्टर्ब. Is he the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vishnu? Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So Lord Brahmaji is wondering, right? And he's perturbed, khedayan manah, like in one kshan, you know, from a small, appearing from the nose and then became like an elephant, right? And is he Bhagwan? Says, Swadhi Bhagwan Shesha. Yeah? Is he the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vishnu? So it says here, right, this, since Brahma is the supermost person in the universe and he had never before experienced such a form, he could guess that the wonderful appearance of the boar was an incarnation of Vishnu. The uncommon features symptomatic of the incarnation of Godhead can bewilder even the mind of Brahma. So what to say of like common human beings like us, right? Ravi?
इति मीमांसतस्य ब्रह्मण स सुरमभि भगवान यज्ञ पुरुषो जग जगर जागेंद्र सन्निभि. व्हाइल ब्रह्मा वाज डेलिब्रेटिंग विद हिज सन द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड हेड विष्णु रोड ट्रेमेंडसली लाइक अ ग्रेट माउंटेन.
हरे कृष्णा. Right? So, जब ब्रह्मा जी सबसे डिस्कस कर रहे हैं तो लॉर्ड विष्णु रोयर लाइक अ ग्रेट माउंटेन. सो निशा.
ब्रह्मानं हर्षयामास हरिस्तांश्च द्वितोत्तमान स्वगर जीतेन ककुभ प्रतिस्वनयता विभु. The omnipotent supreme personality of Godhead enlivened Brahma and the other highly elevated Brahmins by again roaring with his uncommon voice, which echoed in all directions. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So that voice enlivened all the highly elevated Brahmins. Okay.
Yeah. निशम्यते घररित स्वखेद क्षरी क्षयिष्णु माया यसुकरस्य जनस्तप सत्य निवासिनस्ते त्रिभि पवित्रैर् मुन योग योगृणन् स्मः. When the great sages and the thinkers who are residents of Janaloka, Tapaloka, Satyoga, heard the tremendous voice of Lord Bor, which was all auspicious sound of all magnificent God, merciful God, they chanted auspicious chants from the three Vedas. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So the important thing is the Janlok, Taplok and Satyalok, right? If you remember, we have 14 Loks, right? Highest is Satyalok. That's where Lord Brahma resides. Yeah. And then you have Janlok and Taplok, right? Then you have Devata's Lok and then Guru Lok and all that. And then of course you have Prithvi, and then below us we have all the seven other Loks, right? Tal, Vital, Talatal and all that. Like Patal is the last one. Right. So when this, so during one kalp of Brahma, right, of Lord Brahma, one kalp is one day of Lord Brahma. And as we remember, how many Manus appear in one day of Lord Brahma? If you remember one kalp?
14, I think.
14.
12. Yeah. So 12 Manus appear in one kalp, one day of Lord Brahma. And between the Manu's appearance, also Pralaya happens, right? So one is Lord Brahma himself lives for, I think, some 150 or 300 trillion years, right? And then the whole big Pralaya happens. But the small Pralayas happen after every Manu, okay? But then in the small Pralaya, what happens is all the Rishis, Munis and all that, they move up. When they see the Pralayas coming, they... I don't know if you remember, we read at one place where they move up to Janlok or Taplok, okay? And then everything else gets devastated, like, right, the water, take place. So Janlok, Taplok and Satyalok, as you say, Jan, Tapah, Satya, Nivasi, Naste, right? So they all started chanting the auspicious chants from the three Vedas. Yeah, it says Tribhya Pavitre Munyo Adrinan Sma. So they all started chanting. Yeah. And actually, nice purport. Let's read this, Tarun.
The word Maya, Maya, Maya is very significant in this verse. Maya means mercy, specific knowledge, and also illusion. Therefore, Lord Bor is everything. He is merciful, he is all knowledge, and his illusion also. The sound which he vibrated as the Bor incarnation was answered by the Vedic hymns of the great sages in the planets Janaloka, Tapaloka, and Satyaloka. The highest intellectual and pious living entities live in those planets. And when they heard the extraordinary voice of the Bor, they could understand that the specific sound was vibrated by the Lord and no one else. Therefore, they replied by praying to the Lord with Vedic hymns. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Yeah. Anilji?
Yeah. The earth planet was submerged in the mire, but on hearing the sound of the Lord, the inhabitants of the higher planets were all jubilant because they knew that the Lord was there to deliver the earth. Therefore, Brahma and all the sages, such as Bhrigu, Brahma's other sons, and learned Brahmanas, were enlivened, and they concertedly joined in praising the Lord with the transcendental vibrations of the Vedic hymns. The most important is the Brahman Naradya Purana verse, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Yeah, so that's why this is also called the Mahamantra. Yeah. And it's coming from Brihan Naradiya Puran. Yeah. That's the Puran from which this mantra has been advised, right? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So this is so important, like, for us. And that's why we begin with the chanting of this Maha Mantra. And in fact, we do it along with Srila Prabhupada's voice, which is even, you know, greater and more pure, most pure. So it's really nice, Nisha.
Tesham satam vedavitan murtir brahma vardhayatma gunanuvadam vinadhya bhuyo vibhudo dayaya gajendra lilo jalama vivesh. Playing like an elephant, he entered into the water after roaring again in reply to the Vedic prayers by the great devotees. The Lord is the object of the Vedic prayers, and thus he understood that the devotees' prayers were meant for him. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Yeah. So everyone is praying, and you are Ravi.
उक्षीत वाल कच्चर कठोर सटा विदुन वन कर रोम शत्वप पुराह ताभ्र सित दृष्ट इक्षा ज्योतिर भावसे भगवान महीत्र. Before entering the water to rescue the earth, Lord Boar flew in the sky, slashing his tail, his hard hair squirreling. His very glance was luminous, and he scattered the clouds in the sky with his hooves and his glittering white tusk. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Right? So describing how Vara avatar happened and how this happened. And again, nice purport. Let's read this, Nisha.
When the Lord is offered prayers by his devotees, his transcendental activities are described. Here are some of the transcendental features of Lord Boar. As the residents of the upper three planetary system offered their prayers to the Lord, it is understood that his body expanded throughout the sky, beginning from the topmost planet, Brahmalok or Satyalok. It is stated in the Brahma Samhita that his eyes are the sun and the moon. Therefore, his very glance over the sky was as illuminating as the sun or the moon. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Anilji?
The Lord is described herein as Mahidraha, which means either a big mountain or the sustainer of the earth. In other words, the Lord's body was as big and hard as the Himalayan mountains. Otherwise, how was it possible that he kept the entire earth on the support of his white tusks? The poet Jayadev, a great devotee of the Lord, has sung of the incident in his prayers for the incarnations. Basati Dasana Sikhar Dharatn Dharantatava Lagna Sasuni Kalanka Kaleva Nimagna Kesava Drata Sukara Rupa Jaya Jagadisha Hare. All glories to the Lord Keshav Krishna, who appeared as the boar. The earth was held between his tusks, which appeared like the scars on the moon. Hare Krishna.
कृष्णा. सो कैसे वरा है अवतार में डिस्क्राइब किया जा रहा है. निशा.
ग्राणेन पृथ्व्याः पदवीं विजिग्रण प्रोडा पदेशः स्वयं द्वरांग करालं त्रष्टो अप्यकराल द्रुप्या मुविद Viprana Grunato Avishatkam. He was personally the Supreme Lord Vishnu and was therefore transcendental, yet because he had the body of a hog, he He searched after the earth by smell. His tusks were fearful and he glanced over the devotees, Brahmins, engaged in offering prayers. Thus he entered the water. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. No? सव्रज कूटांगनी न पात वेग विशीर्ण कोक्षीय स्तन यन्नु द्वनवान उत सृष्ट दीर्घोर्मि भुजेरिवात चक्षु क्रोश यज्ञेश्वर पाहि मेति. सो डिवाइडिंग इनटू द वाटर लाइक अ ग्रेट माउंटेन लॉर्ड बर्ड डिवाइडेड द मिडल ऑफ द ओशियन एंड टू हाई वेव्स अपीयर्ड एज इन द आर्म्स ऑफ द ओशियन which cried loudly as if praying to the Lord, O Lord of all sacrifices, please do not cut me in two, kindly give me protection. Right? So it says even the Mahasagar is praying to the Lord, like don't divide me into two. Now it says even the great ocean was perturbed by the falling of the mountain like body of the transcendental Lord, and it appeared to be frightened as if death were imminent. Next, Tarun.
Prikuru reha shrupriha dharyam stad apa utpara param triparu rasyam rasayam dadarsha ga tatra susupursur agre यम जित्वा धादानिम स्वायम अभ्यादता दत्त. Translation. Lord Boar penetrated the water with his hooves, which were like sharp arrows, and found the limit of the ocean, although it was unlimited. He saw the earth, the resting place for all living beings, lying as it was in the beginning of creation, and he personally lifted it. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, right? So in the form of boar, he personally lifted it. Let's read this purport actually. Nice, Anisha.
The word rasyam is sometimes interpreted to mean Ratsala, the lowest planetary system, but that is not applicable in this connection. According to Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, the earth is seven times superior to the other planetary system, namely Tal, Atal, Talatal, Vital, Rasatal, Patal, etc. Therefore, the earth cannot be situated in the Rasatal planetary system. It is described in the Vishnu Dharma. Patal Muleshwara Bhoga Samhatu Vinyasa Pado Prithvim Cha Vibhartha Yasayo Pamano Na Bhavivo So Kyuto Mamastu Mangalaya Vivarde Harihi. Therefore, the Lord found the earth on the bottom of the Garbhodaka ocean, where the planets rest during the devastation at the end of Brahma's day. Hare Krishna.
Right. So at the end of the Brahma's day, planets rest in Garbhodaksha ocean. And I think here it says Rasayam. So that's what the clarification is, because you remember we are just talking about all these seven planets below earth, right? So those are the names, like below us is Tal, then Atal, Talatal, Vital, Rasatal and Patal. Okay, so it's not that difficult to remember these names, right? So below Prithvi you have those, yeah, Tal, Atal, Talatal, Vital, Rasatal and Patal. But anyway, but what it says is earth is, of course, superior than the lower planets. And then, of course, we have other superior planets above Earth. We saw like Janlok and Taplok. All right. So, Anilji?
Yeah. Sudrasta Yodhat महीम निमग्ना स उत्थिता संरुचे रसाया तत्रापि दैत्यम गदया पतंतम सुना वसंदीपित तीव्र मन्यु लॉर्ड बोर वेरी इजली टू द अर्थ ऑन हिज टस्क एंड गॉट इट आउट ऑफ द वाटर. कैन यू मूव इट अप प्लीज. Thus he appeared very splendid. Then his anger glowing like the Sudarshan wheel, he immediately killed the demon Hiranyaka, although he tried to fight with the Lord. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Right? So who can like hold the earth on his tusks? Right? The whole of earth, the whole globe, and then get it out of the water. Yeah? So that's what Varaha Avatar, did and got it out of the water. Yeah? And I just read this, Tarun.
According to Srila Jiva Goswami, the Vedic literatures describe the incarnation of Lord Varaha Bore in two different devastations, namely the Chakshusa devastation and the Svayambhuva devastation. This particular appearance of the boar incarnation actually took place in the Svayambhuva devastation, when all planets other than the higher ones, Jana, Mahar, and Satya, merged in the water of devastation. This particular incarnation of the boar was seen by the inhabitants of the planets below them, mentioned above. Sri Vishwanatha Chakravarti suggested that the sage Maitreya amalgamated both the boar incarnations in different devastations and summarized them in his description of Vidura. Hare Krishna.
Yeah, so what it's saying essentially is like Svayambhuva devastation, like after the devastation, Manu is born, right? So Svayambhuva, so that is one described, but he's saying that Maitreya Muni summarized that as long as the other Manu, Chakshush Manu, right, the devastation happened after that. So he described and summarized both together is what is being mentioned here. So we are going to stop since we only have 1 minute left. So we'll hear our kirtan and again now have a long weekend. And then we'll see you on Monday. Yeah, we'll restart from the Varaha Avatar. So, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.